It's a fruit that's easy to grow, and you can eat it in all stages of growth. And it comes from a plant that offers protection from the elements and can be made into fabric. What if it can also grow where 80% of the world's hungry people live? It sounds like a fantasy, doesn't it? But it's not. What is this miracle fruit? And what does its history have to do with Pacific Islanders? Captain Cook. Mutiny. And insect repellent. Keep watching as we explore a fruit to help feed the world. Breadfruit looks like a bumpy green egg and can be 10 to 30 centimeters long and 9 to 20 centimeters wide. It's highly nutritious, and almost 50 varieties of breadfruit contain all the amino acids. And it has plenty of carbohydrates and protein. But that's not all. It's also a great source of antioxidants and numerous vitamins and minerals. When small, it tastes like an artichoke. Fully grown breadfruit is starchy and tastes like a potato. And when it's even more mature, it becomes soft like a dessert. When toasted, it smells like baked bread. Oh, I get it, breadfruit. A single large tree can grow 400 to 600 fruits, and it needs less maintenance than rice and wheat. Native to New Guinea, breadfruit spread throughout the Pacific Islands. It's been a staple food for Pacific Islanders for at least 3,000 years and is a traditional part of Hawaiian culture. Europeans first became interested in breadfruit in the 18th century. In 1769, Captain James Cook sailed to Tahiti to check out its potential as a food source. In 1776, the French exported the fruit from the Philippines to colonies in the Caribbean. Not to be outdone, a decade later, the British sent the HMS Bounty to the South Pacific to collect this miracle fruit and bring it to the British West Indies. That storm-tossed journey took 10 months. Upon arrival, the crew spent their days collecting breadfruit and the night cavorting with locals. Captain Bligh was the only commissioned officer, and he was frustrated by his crew's lack of discipline. He accused members of his crew of stealing rations. Their reaction? They mutinied and set Bligh and his loyal crew members adrift. Bligh eventually returned to Tahiti and brought breadfruit to Jamaica. But breadfruit is important for other reasons. Its male flowers can repel disease-borne mosquitoes. The tree excretes a sap used as chewing gum and waterproof caulking for boats and homes. People can harvest the bark's fibers without harming the tree and make them into mosquito nets, clothing, and paper. Is there anything this tree can't do? Interplanting breadfruit trees with crops such as mango, papaya, and sweet potatoes provides food throughout the year. You can eat raw breadfruit, but people usually bake, boil, fry, roast, or steam it. Its starchy nature means that anything you can do with a potato, you can do with breadfruit. It's even called a tree potato. Since it's nutritious and easy to grow, it is a superstar in the fight against world hunger. Organizations such as Global Breadfruit are working to distribute the trees globally. Their efforts have resulted in 83,000 breadfruit trees now growing in 40 countries. Unfortunately, the trees only grow in tropical regions. The slightest frost will kill them. It also takes 3 to 5 years for a tree to begin bearing fruit. But once it does, it can provide food for generations. Today, 80% of the world's hungry reside in tropical or subtropical areas. Breadfruit could help to feed these people and provide a stable crop for local farmers. Breadfruit is one choice for helping to end hunger. Another could be 3D printed food. We'll take a look at that one on another episode of Origins of Food.